So dear children, welcome to the fourth module of chapter Magnetic Effects of Electric Current.
Now let us understand a convenient method of finding the direction of magnetic field associated with a current carrying conductor. Okay, so if you just consider this as a straight current carrying conductor along which the current is passing in the direction like this. Okay, so imagine that you are holding this current carrying conductor in your right hand and this thumb is showing the direction of current, then the fingers wrap around is showing the direction of magnetic field. If the direction of current is downward like this, thumb is showing the direction of current and this fingers are showing the direction of magnetic field. And this is called the right hand thumb. It is also known as Maxwell's screw rule. Why is it so? According to Maxwell's screw rule, if you are driving yourself a corkscrew, the direction of current is along the movement of the screw and the rotation of the screw is in the direction of magnetic field. Is it clear? So, right hand thumb rule or Maxwell's screw rule. You have understood the pattern of magnetic field lines around a straight current carrying conductor. Now, suppose you bend the straight current carrying conductor into the form of a loop, then what will be the nature of the magnetic field lines? We will understand this.
We know that the magnetic field produced by a current carrying straight wire depends inversely on the distance from it. Similarly, at every point of a current carrying circular loop, the concentric circles representing the magnetic field around it would become larger and larger as we move away from the wire. By the time we reach at the center of the circular loop, the arcs of these big circles would appear as straight lines. Every point on the wire carrying current would give rise to the magnetic field appearing as straight lines at the center of the loop. Now let us understand in detail the magnetic field around a current carrying circular loop. In order to find the magnetic field due to a coil, it is held in a vertical plane and is made to pass through a smooth cardboard in such a way that the sender O of the coil lies at the cardboard. A current is passed through the coil and iron fillings are sprinkled on the cardboard. These iron fillings arrange themselves in a pattern similar to the one we can see here. This pattern represents the magnetic field lines due to the coil. In order to find the direction of magnetic field lines, we can use a compass needle. The pattern of magnetic field lines so obtained is shown here, and from this pattern, we can understand some of the important points. Firstly, the magnetic field lines near the coil are nearly circular and concentric. This is due to the reason that segment of the coil in contact with the board at the points A and B are almost like straight conductors. The direction of the field lines can also be found by applying right hand thumb rule. The field lines are in the same direction in the space enclosed by the coil. Near the center of the coil, the magnetic field lines are nearly straight and parallel. As such, the magnet field at the center of the coil can be taken to be uniform. The direction of the magnetic field at the center is perpendicular to the plane of the coil. As we move towards the center of the coil, the strength of the magnetic field increases and the magnetic field is maximum at the center. This is due to the reason that the two magnetic fields, one due to the semicircle segment of coil A and the other due to semicircle segment of B, combines each other. We know that the magnetic field produced by a current carrying wire at a given point depends directly on the current passing through it. Therefore, if there is a circular coil having n turns, the field produced is n times as large as that produced in a single turn. This is because the current in each circular turn has the same direction and the field due to each turn then just adds up. You understood the magnetic field due to a straight current carrying conductor and the circular loop along with right hand thumb rule. Thank you.